सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पाद शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। ओम समस्त जन कल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरम् सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरम्। ओम अखंडमंडलाकारं व्याप्तं येन चराचरं तत्पदं दर्शितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुरेव परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। त्वमेव माता च पिता त्वमेव त्वमेव बंधुश्च सखा त्वमेव त्वमेव विद्या द्रविणं त्वमेव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव देव त्वमेव सर्वं गुरुदेव देव। श्री सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय। I'll sing one bhajan on Guru. This is Chinmaya Mission famous bhajan. Swami Brahmananji's cassettes, it is there. Om Guru Nadha Jaya Guru Nadha. Om Guru Nadha Jaya Guru Nadha. शिव गुरुनाथ स्वामीनाथ शिव गुरुनाथ स्वामीनाथ। ओम गुरुनाथ जय गुरुनाथ। चिन्मय रूप जय गुरुनाथ चिन्मय रूप जय गुरुनाथ। ओम गुरुनाथ जय गुरुनाथ। ओम गुरुनाथ जय गुरुनाथ। ओम गुरुनाथ जय गुरुनाथ। अनाधनाथ दीनबंधो अनाधनाथ दीनबंधो अद्भुत चरिता जय गुरुनाथ। अद्भुत चरिता जय गुरुनाथ। ओम नाथा जय गुरु नाथा, ओम गुरु नाथा जय गुरु नाथा। श्री सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय। అద్భుత చరిత జయ గురునాథ. గురు చరిత అద్భుతం. అద్భుతం మీన్స్ వండర్. ఇఫ్ యూ సీ అవర్ పూజ్య గురుదేవ్, హీ హిమ్సెల్ఫ్ ఈజ్ ఎ వండర్. ఎవ్రీ ఆస్పెక్ట్ యాజ్ ఎ జ్ఞాని హీ స్టేస్ దేర్ ఓన్లీ. ఏక సత్య విషయ. సంబడి ఆస్క్డ్ వాట్ ఈజ్ యువర్ రిలేషన్ విత్ తపోవన్జీ మహారాజ్. He said, I am Mauni. I am Mauni means I don't open even my mind also. Completely silent. Whatever he says, he said, that's all. Bhakti. And karma, if we see, it's not easy to do a Jeevan Mukta like this. Because we are somewhere, somewhere, somewhere. If they see from there, from the heights of the truth, the reality, what we are giving for the things and beings, it is like, you know, stupidity only. Many times he used to say in Viveka Chudamani, one mad fellow was there. Generally, mad fellows, they carry one bag. Whole bag only kachida only. They collect used, what we call, drink bottles and this and that. And they keep so preciously that bag. If we ask that particular mad person, why you carry this bag? This is like a stupidity. What is there in it? He says, no, you don't touch it. It is my bag. I collected this one. This is my own. And they love it. Actually, our life is also like that. He said, Shankaracharya said like that. We collect so much. It's all garbage only. He wants to, you know, teach us about that real Brahma, Satswarupa, Jnana Swarupa, Ananda Swarupa, Eka Satyam, no Raga, no Dvesha, nothing, pure, pure, pure. Adbhuta Charita, but they are ready to teach. That is their greatness. They are ready to teach wherever we are. Somebody asked Swami Gurudev, why do you like this mud? He said, you know, do you know one thing? Lotus will come from mud only. So I expect some lotus from every heart. It may be mud now. Sometime one lotus may come. Then that fragrance will come. He will evolve. That jiva will evolve. Adbhuta Charita Jai Gurunatha. It's a great blessing to get Gurudev like Guru and following his teachings, everything. Hari Om. Tattva Bodha. Vasudevendra Yogindram Natva Jnana Pradam Gurum Mumukshunam Hitardhaya Tattvabodho vidhiyate. This is the prayer. And then Guru said, I am going to tell about what is Atma. Because this Atma is your own identity, your truth. So we need a Guru. Guru said Atma. Then student asked, oh my dear Guru, please tell what is this Atma. Then Guru defined with A, B, C, D, with four columns. A, he said, my dear student, Atma is Shariratraya Vyatirittaha. It is not gross body, it is not subtle body, it is not causal body. Other than these three, whatever there in your personality, that is the self, that is the truth. Then he asked, can you explain gross body, subtle body and causal body? He explained. So A is over. Then the next question is, this Atma is avastatraya sakshi. This atma is a sakshi, witness. Witness to whom, Swamiji? Witness to three states of experiences. One is called waking state, dream state, and deep sleep state. This is not waking, this is not dream, this is not deep sleep. This is the witness for the above three. And he explained what is waking state. And he explained what is dream state. Now he is going to explain about what is deep sleep state. If this question comes to us, we say, Swamiji, what is there to know about deep sleep? We know deep sleep. Completely we sleep, that is called deep sleep. But this student, he is asking, hey Guru, this is in page number 49. He is asking the question. Adha means now. Shushuptyavastaka 58 in your page number. Shushuptyavastaka. What do you mean by shushupti avastha? You said deep sleep. There is one experience. What is that? See, the answer is aham kimapi na janami sukhena maya nidranubhuyat iti shushuptyavastha iti shushuptyavastha. This is called Shushupti Avastha, deep sleep state. What is that Guru is saying? See, the experience in Shushupti Avastha, deep sleep state is, this is the experience. Aham kimapi na janami. I did not know anything. This is the experience. This is one anubhavam. The nature of anubhavam, the nature of experience is, I did not know anything. Haikini, in deep sleep, what will be our knowledge? I don't know anything. That is also experience. And then one more thing is there in deep sleep state. That is, sukhena maya nidra anubhuyat. Maya, by me, sukhena nidra anubhuyat. I experienced good sleep. These two are the experiences in deep sleep state. One aspect is, I did not know anything. Second aspect is, I slept very well. Here, karana sharira abhimani atma. This atma, he identifies with causal body. Not gross body, not subtle body. This atma identifies with causal body. And he has one name. His name is Prajna. Iti uchyate. We call him as Prajna. This is the complete dissection about deep sleep state. The same person, if he identifies with waking state, we call him Vishwa. Because he is complete. He is using all his equipments. In dream, his name is Taijasa. Taijasa means it is an imaginary light is there. That's why his name is Taijasa. Swamiji, now Mahatmas kept this man name is Prajna, the deep sleeper. In English, we call. Aina? This deep sleeper name is Prajna. the translation for prajna is prakrushtena ajnaha, well ignorant. Aina, this is the experience in that state. Well ignorant, completely ignorant. That's why we call him as prajna. We don't know anything. It is not like waking and a dream. Complete ignorance. That's why his name is prajna. Swamiji, this is about a deep sleep state. We may say deep sleep is nothing, deep sleep is nothing, but no. Actually, once I told, this causal body is the root for the above two. All our vasanas, all our personality will be there in unmanifested form, as it is. That's why when we woke up, the same Venkata Chaitanya who goes for sleep, the same personality will sprout out. Some other man will not come. This is a beautiful cycle. Beautiful cycle and very, very systematic. That's why they say Prakriti is more powerful than man, because the laws of Prakriti are very perfect. Here also we have this law. Whatever the inherent tendencies, whatever my personality, whatever my nature, I'll keep everything in deep sleep as it is. And when we came out from deep sleep, we sprout out as it is. Same Venkata Chaitanya will come. Nothing. It will preserve as it is. This is called deep sleep state. Swamiji, we are studying Tattva Bodha. Can you give some more light on this deep sleep state? Of course we give. Actually, there are four points are there to know about what is this deep sleep state, Shushupti Avastha. Four points. They are very subtle. We need little subtlety to understand this particular state. Swamiji, why we need is, while experiencing this state, we are absent. This eye is absent. This intellect is absent. Still that is there. That's why to understand, we need little subtlety. Okay, Swamiji, we try. You explain. First point is, in deep sleep, complete ignorance is there. No emotions, no thoughts, no worldly objects. Hai ki nahi? Yes, Swamiji. In deep sleep, no objects. So gross body is not working. Even this is not working. It doesn't know how it is in deep sleep. That's why Mahatma says, in deep sleep, for example, one cloth shatters, we don't mind. We don't mind for ourselves. We don't mind for our neighbor also. We excuse him. Because deep sleep mein wo chalta hai, sabko aisa hota hai, usme wrong kya, what is wrong in it? So gross body is absent, all his business is absent. And subtle body, no emotions, no thoughts, no duality, nothing. Then it's a homogeneous experience, we say. But here is the Vedantic concept is there. But this experience will be illuminated by that pure consciousness. Capital I, our true identity, it will illumine even this deep sleep state also. There is a knowledge of this absence of experiences also. Listen carefully. There is a knowledge of this experience of absence of things. We know this is a state of absence. That's why when we came out of from this deep sleep, we say, I slept very well. How it is possible? There is some knowledge light is there. That is our capital I, pure consciousness. This is one thing. So there is a knowledge of this absence also, one. Second thing is, in this state, we enjoy bliss. There is nothing. See the greatness of deep sleep. There is no world. There is no subtle world. There is no gross world. Even though we enjoy the state of experience, we draw from some bliss. That's why Gadha Nidra is not horrible. Gadha Nidra is a happy state of experience. We enjoy our sleep from where it is coming. Generally, our knowledge is happiness will be from objects or emotions or thoughts. If a nice thought comes, I enjoy. If a beautiful emotion comes, I enjoy. If a desired object comes, I enjoy. But in deep sleep, all are absent, still I enjoy. Still I am a state of bliss. They say this is the source of bliss, Atma Anandam. This is not Vastu Anandam, this is Atma Anandam. There is Atma Jnanam also, there is Atma Anandam also. But the problem is, the person who should know this is Atma Jnanam and Atma Anandam, he is slept. He is ignorant of this source. That is the problem. That's why in Yoga Shastra they say, this is the subtle difference between Yoga Samadhi and deep sleep. In Yoga Samadhi also, he experiences exactly this only. There are no objects, no emotions, no thoughts, only Atma Jnanam and Atma Anandam. There he knew that. He was aware of those two things, Atma Jnanam and Atma Anandam. That's why it become yoga. Great state of experience. We call it as yoga. Here also same. There is no world. There is no subtle world. There is no gross world. There is only Atma Jnanam, there is only Atma Anandam. But the person, the meditator, he slept. He caught another thought that is called deep sleep. This is a tamas. He doesn't know what he is. That's why he cannot turn towards that light. But the experience is same. In deep sleep, it happens. That's why this state we call as prajna. Prajna means extremely ignorant. I don't know anything. Aham kimapi na janami. We hold that thought. That's why they say the purity of our mind should be like this. In deep sleep also, if someone awakes, how much awareness, how much jagruti is needed to that jiva, if he gets that, he always in the Atma Ananda only. It is easy only. How, Swamiji? If we know how to witness these objects, how to witness our emotions, how to witness our thoughts, then always we will be very close to this Atma Jnana and Atma Ananda. This process is called dhyana. So this is one point about deep sleep. Yes, Swamiji. Any other thing, Swamiji? Yes. This is another new aspect about deep sleep. Okay, Swamiji. Tell Swamiji, what is that? This is also a new point. They say, in waking state, we hold two subtle thoughts. In waking state, now where we are all. Swamiji, what are the two subtle thoughts? One is doership Another one is enjoyership. In Vedantic language, we say one is called Kartritva Bhava, another is called Bhoktritva Bhava. These two are very prominent in waking state. Kartritva Bhava means doership. I am doing, I am doing, I am doing. For every activity, we put this thought. I am listening. This listening is a doing. Before that, you put I am. Completely, I am listening. This is called doership. And then the return of this listening is, I am understanding. This is enjoyership. These two will be there in every activity. I am eating, I am enjoying. I am eating is doership. I am enjoying is bhoktritva. I am enjoying the rasa, whatever the food. For everything, you act and you will get the response. You act and you will get the response. These two will be the prominent subtle thoughts in waking state. In dream state, you know, that kartritva bhava will absent. That will be sleep. Only enjoyership will be there. That's why after dream, what we say, you know, I enjoyed or I scared about my dream. That much only our print experience. We cannot say, I created my dream. I created my nice things. There will be no kartritva bhava in a dream. Hai na? This is our own experience. No one say, I created my dream. But everyone say, I enjoyed my dream. Only bhoktritva bhava. And the third one is this. This is shushupti. Here they say, very, very subtle three thoughts will be absent even. Very subtle their thoughts. The thoughts are, one is time concept, space concept, duality concept. These three concepts are very subtle in the other states of experiences. Whereas here in deep sleep, there is no time concept. That's why if somebody asks how long you slept, it's a time concept. How long you slept? I don't know. I slept well, that's all. How long you slept, that sleeper cannot answer that. There is no time concept in deep sleep. And the more, where did you sleep? There is no time concept in deep sleep. We don't know where we are. Where is our location? In waking state, all the time we need location. Swamiji, please send your location, then we can catch you. In deep sleep, there is no location. Huh? Where you are? On my bed, Swamiji, on your bed, your body is there. I am asking about you. There is no space concept. And very important is, there is no duality concept. Duality means you and me. This duality is there in waking. So solid. I can differentiate everything. Tapa, 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 tapa. Because of this duality concept. In dream also it is there. But whereas in deep sleep, homogeneous. That's why it is shanti. Our mind did not go this breaking, cutting process. Tukda, 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 tukda kartayam. In waking and dream. Whereas in deep sleep, no cutting. Homogeneous. Single thought. That's why all agitations gone. Projections gone. La duality is gone. That's why it's very close to its own source. One and only problem is, it doesn't know what it is. That ignorance is there. If he knows where he is, that subtle thought, it is a Brahmananda. We don't break our mind. In Jesus' teaching, this thought is there. Israel, he went there and he sees one God's temple. There, it's poetically, he says, they cut some pieces to sell. There, Jesus teach this thought on. Generally, if we understand, generally, we cut our mind into pieces, 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 pieces. For every piece, so much garbage we keep. He is that, she is that, this is that, this is different. That is, we are all cutting pieces. He says, stop, cut the mind. You stop, cut the mind, then you will enjoy. Catch the connective thread, which is one in everyone. If you see that, then you cannot cut anyone. You cannot say you and me, he and it, rich and poor, great and no, nothing. In deep sleep only, we will be in that state. In everywhere, we will cut, tuck, 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 tuck. Very, very pity and sad thing, you know. Puj Guruji, Swami Tejomayananda used to say, in Sravana Sadhana also, while listening great signs of Vedanta also, our intellect and mind use this kind of cheap technique. Whatever the guru says, our intellect cut it. Arre, listen first. Let it be whoever speaking, let him speak. You don't cut his thought. Allow it. He call it as a sarota. Sarota means there is a mission in India. When we do this mango pickle, we cut it with this. Same way, we don't allow the knowledge to enter into our buddhi. We cut with our previous knowledge, likes and dislikes. So much thing we put it and we spoil the knowledge like anything. Even in Punya Sravana also. Allow it. As it is, Bhagavan Shankaracharya used to say, this is called Yadhavat Sravanam. Sravanam should be, the listening should be Yadhavat. Whatever he is speaking, allow it as it is. Then you think later. While receiving, please don't do this Sarota project. Cut, 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 cut. We do it. No, we should not cut mind like. That's why we are getting all this kind of pain, sorrow, agony, differences. So many differences we keep because of this subtle habit. Cutting the mind. This is second. Swamiji, what will be the third one? Third one is, in deep sleep, third point is, see, waking and dream, people will dream different types of dreams. People will experience different type of experiences in waking. But, see, but the deep sleep state experience is one and only and same to all. Aina? Deep sleep, the nidra, the sleep is same to everyone, whether you are a king or you are a beggar, but this is the common. That's why in Telugu, one great Mahatma is there, his name Annamayya. He has written one song like Brahma Mukkate, Parabrahma Mukkate. Brahma is one and Parabrahma is one. There he writes, Nindara Raju Nidrinchu Nidrayu Ukate. Andane pandu unna bantu nidra okate. The king is sleeping in the palace and the servant is sleeping outside the gate. In waking state, both are extremely different. King is king, servant is servant. We don't know where he is. But in nidra, in this state, both are one. In deep sleep only, we are one. If we drop that also, that ignorance also, then one ekam. This is, and the final one is, already I told, in deep sleep, we are prajna. Prajnaha means we are completely ignorant about our own true nature. These four will be the four points to know about our deep sleep state. But the main knowledge is something else. That is, you are not this deep sleeper. You are not this deep sleeper. You are the witness. You are the pure consciousness. Even it can witness this deep sleep. You are that. Not this ignorant man. Not this slumbery man. Not this state of experience you. You are the witness. That's why he defined Atma as Avastatraya Sakshi. See our purity. This is the glory of our own nature. That's why they say Vedanta is great science. Vidyanam Atma Vidyaham. Bhagavan says in Bhagavad Gita, I am the knowledge. Among the knowledges, I am the self-knowledge. This is our glow. Such a purity. Even now, we are Asanga Swarupa. Even now, we are Shuddha Chaitanya. You are the witness of even this slumber state also. We know that. See, these three experiences, one negates another. Our Swamiji, Swami Advaita Anandaji, is our residential acharya in Vedanta course. He used to say, one dhakka marke dusre wala baithte hain. Dhakka marke means he will throw that one and the second one will come. These three will behave like that only. When the deep sleep comes, this deep sleep, it will throw the waking state. You get out of it. I don't like you. I want to sleep. This is our attitude. When dream comes, we ignore this waking state. Let it be whatever beauty. We say, my dream is so beautiful. Dhakka marke baitta ek experience. They negate each other. At the same time, we cannot enjoy two experiences at a time. No person waker and no person deep sleeper. No. When deep sleeper, he cannot be waker. When waker, he cannot be dreamer. One throws out the other and he stays. Now check, among the three experiences, who is the common one? Who cannot be negated? That is me. How can you say, Swamiji, that is you? Because I know these three. I am the witness. Purely I know. These three are the experiences are passing on me. I am the substratum. That I is me, unattached, complete pure. Pure means extremely pure, not scented pure, not cleanly pure, extremely pure, shuddham eva. Because why I am saying is, in Jagradavastha, we label some things as pure. Even that purity also cannot touch my Atma purity. That is the glory. Swamiji, this place is so pure, so clean. But I am the illuminator of that purity, that clarity also. Untouched. That is Atma, right? You. Your glory. I am speaking. These are all just shades only. They play and go, play and go, play and go. You are king of these things. Understood? Live like that, Guru said. Live like master. Live like Maharaj. Let it be. Let it be. They are play. We may act like a beggar in drama. But we don't forget, you know, our own identity. We know who we are. These three are the three roles. Sometime waker, sometime dream sleeper, sometime. This is the beauty of Vedanta. Vedanta does not hold what is there in Jagrata, what is there in waking, what is there in deep sleep. Vedanta says what you are in these three experiences. They are very colorful. They will catch our mind. Swamiji, it is easy to, you say, whole waking state, you know, you can see like a wetness. This is a role I am playing. Exactly this only. This way, whole waking state is a role we are playing. We are different from the role in this drama. That is called pure knowledge. And we are much more bigger, much more greater than these three experiences. Okay, Guruji, we understood. Then Guru is not leaving. My student, you have to think more about your true nature. If you establish your own identity, then well and good. Now, I am going to teach the third definition for Atma. That is, Atma is Panchakosha Atitaha. He defined about Atma in the definition, the self is beyond five sheets of our personality. We have five layers in our personality. The self is beyond this. Now that point he is taking care. Panchakoshaha ke? The question. Here ke is used because panchakoshas are plural. What are the panchakoshas? What are the five sheets in my personality? Panchakoshaha ke? Student asks. And the guru is replying. You should by heart all the names of panchakoshas. They are annamayaha, pranamayaha, manomayaha, vijnanamayaha, anandamayaha, iti. Five. Annamayaha, pranamayaha, manomayaha, vijnanamayaha, anandamayaha. Food sheath, vital air sheath, mental sheath, intellectual sheath, bliss sheath, if we translate. Okay, Swamiji, we can by heart five Sanskrit words. Annamayaha, pranamayaha, manomayaha, vijnanamayaha, anandamayaha. Easy. Five sheets. In old forts, if we see, the king's palace is in the middle. Around that palace, there are prakaras. Circularly, they build protection shields, what we call. I know. Here for this Atma, we have five this kind of what we call prakara. If you go to temple in India, there will be prakaras. In the middle, Sri Venkateswara Swami will be there. And they say, Swamiji, this is Ananda Nilayam. This is Sampangi Pradakshana. This is Mahapradakshana. And we have to cross 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In the middle of the fifth one, Bhagavan will stay. Here also same. In our personality, we have five layers, five coverings. Annamaya, pranamaya, manomaya, vijnanamaya, anandamaya. And this Atma is atitaha, beyond all these five. Step 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then Bhagavan is there. If you go to Tirumala, the first prakara they call Mahaprakara. We enter. God is there? No. The next prakara is there, that is called silver prakara, vindi vakili desi. How we entered, Swamiji? We entered vindi vakili. Bhagavan is there? No. Then bangaru vakili is there. This is golden prakara. Swamiji, golden prakara, Bhagavan? No. Then addala mantapa. There is a mirror prakara. Okay, Swamiji, four. One more is there. That is Ananda Nilaya. Blishit. Ananda Prakara. Then the middle Bhagavan. Sri Venkateshwara. Here also we have five sheets on our cell phone. That's why they call as Koshaha. Koshaha means it covers. It covers the truth. They are five. Pujya Guruji, Swami Tejomayananji, he gives two examples for this kind of kosha construction. One is silkworm. We know silkworm. Generally, silkworm with its saliva only, it creates its own koshas, cocoons, they call silkworm. In the same way, so if somebody asks, Swamiji, you said Bhagavan is staying atita of these five koshas, then who build these five koshas? Who build it? With what material we build it? You know the answer is we only build it. Like this silkworm. We only created our own annamaya kosha, our own pranamaya kosha, our own manomaya kosha, our own buddhimaya kosha, and our own anandamaya kosha. You are the cause for your own these sheets, not anyone. This is the one point we should learn. And another example he gives, that is called, if you see the olden swords kings they used to wear, there is a scabbard. Scabbard means that is the kosha for this sword. They keep this sword in the scabbard. Whenever fight is needed, they remove it and they fight it and they will put it back. That is called kosha in Sanskrit. Scabbard they call. These koshas, exactly, they behave like this cupboard. This cupboard will cover the potentiality of the Atma. Atma is completely different. You cannot fight with this kosha because it's a useless thing, but it covers. And we should learn one teaching, that is, even though this cupboard will cover this Atma, but it cannot affect the Atma. This is the great positive thought. In the previous example, this is a little scary example because I myself created my own limitations, my own bondages, and I am crying. I am helpless, I am helpless, I am helpless. But at the same time, these bondages, these limitations, they cannot do anything to Atma. They may be coverings, they may be very strong, they may be powerful, but they cannot do anything to Atma. Atma is always royal, whether you are in bondage or whether you are in the liberation state of experience. Atma is Sarvada Rajate, always King of Kings. That's why he gave these two examples. In the first example, how we created, what is the negative aspect of these koshas? But the second one is, what is the greatness of Atma? Atma is great. They cannot do anything to Atma. Swamiji, you enumerated Annamaya, Pranamaya, Manomaya, Vijnanamaya, Anandamaya koshas. Can you tell, Swamiji, what is Annamaya? Of course we tell. Do you know, what do you mean by Annam? Yeah, we know, Swamiji, rice. No. The translation for annam is food. All food, whatever we eat, that is all annam. Now, okay, Swami, annam we know. Now, annamaya. Annamaya means modifications. Okay, Swamiji. So, this food, what we are taking, it will undergo some modifications. That food modification is nothing but our gross body. We say our gross body is, I am very tall, Swamiji. I am very fair, Swamiji. I am very young, Swamiji. I am beautiful, Swamiji. I am beautiful. They say something, I don't know. Miss India, Swamiji, I am. I am Mr. World, Swamiji, we may say. But Vedanta is saying, this is nothing but modification of food. That is the definition. This is the modification of food. Exactly. Now, think objectively as it is. From where it started its journey. It started its journey with the food of mother and father. And then it entered into the womb of the mother, this body. And it grew. It grew with what? With the food of mother only. Mother eats the food and the baby takes the essence of the food. And we came out. Do we nourish it by anything other than food? Nothing. If we take anything other than food into the body, then it will be like a septic only. We have to take food only. It grew up with food. It born because of food. It grew up because of food. You know, at the end, it will merge into the food only. That is called earth. We may glorify so much thing about the grass body, but one day we have to leave it. You cannot take this grass body to another jiva form. There will be another body is ready to you enter. Here, it will become food for something else. You may burn it or you may bury it. Something will eat it. It will become food for something. So, this layer is completely food-oriented personality. We cannot ignore this. We cannot deny this. In Telugu, one anecdote is they say, Koti Vidyalu Kuti Korake Desi. Man may perform millions of, arts. If you ask them, why are you doing all this creativity, activity, earning, learning? The final answer is to fill my belly. Belly, we cannot ignore. So this is one layer in our personality. This is called annamaya kosha. Millions, trillions, tons of food we ate. Even now we are 60, 70 kilo or 50 kilogram only. We eat so much, but little only can stay in us. The essence of the food. Remaining all we know, we evacuate. This is one layer in our personality. This is not Atma. This is not you. This is the main knowledge. This is not you. This is completely modifications of the food. This is because of food. This is growing because of one day it will be food for something else. How much you may love it. Something will eat it. Swamiji, yes. Luckily, you don't know that thing. We cannot see what is going to happen. Our journey, this journey will end over here. we cry so much, you know, because we love this grass body extremely. That's why every day we make up it, we present it, we clothe it, we scent it so much. Samashta upacharas we do for this grass body. We want to present. If somebody says you are so good, we think, ah, this is good. But they are referring something else. You are so good. If somebody says you are so beautiful, ah, so sweet, Swami. This is all our labeling. But they say, this is nothing but food, my boy. One day it is going to food something. They say, actually, this vairagya vritti we should keep. This vairagya vritti, this is a great blessing. Majestically, we can drop our body that day. We don't cry because I played it. This drama is over. Now I am removing these customs. I will wear another. Vasamsi jirnani yadha vihaya navani grunhati naroparani, Bhagavan says. How we throw the tired clothes and we wear new clothes, in the same way, one day we have to throw this gross body and we have to wear another one. So this is the history of Annamaya Kosam. So in our next class, we will see other layers. The essence is we are not anything. The truth is we are not anything. You are the boss. They are playing on you. As long as you identify with this grass body, so long it will get glow and shine. You sleep. You sleep. Then ask it. It doesn't have anything. Complete log, no good, no bad, no beauty, no ugly, nothing. It doesn't have identity also. There is no need to count this matter also if you are not there. If you are there, then if I want to felicitate you, I have to put a garland on this body only. It will get everything because of my presence. If I am absent, they will throw it out. Gurudev used to say, as long as Shiva stays in this grass body, so long it will be glorified. When he quits, then his wife only asks, let him quit from my home. I cannot keep this dead body. He left already. So we should know this. This knowledge we should keep. What is grass body and what will be my relation with this grass body? That will be helpful our evolution. One day we know who am I. So this knowledge will be helpful. Hari Om. After this class, we will go for question and answer session also. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ओम शांति शांति शांति। हरिः ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरिः ओम।